Hey, it's Travel Gigolo. We really enjoy exploring places that are off the beaten track, and a really cool spot that we've recently visited is Helskloof Pass in the Richtersveld, not too far from Vioolsdrif. So today we're driving through Helskloof Pass on the way to the Richtersveld National Park, and we're coming from the Vioolsdrif area, so it's very close to the Vioolsdrif where we are now. And along the way here, there's a section of the road where people have been building stone cairns for a hell of a long time, many years, I don't know how long, and it's a really amazing sight. There are thousands and thousands of these stone cairns, and people build them as good luck, well, for good luck as they drive through the pass. So who are we to buck with tradition? We are going to build a cairn of our own as well. Seeing this field of stone constructions kind of makes you wonder who constructed the first one, and also how many thousands they actually are, and how many people have driven to this lonely, desolate place over the years. If you find yourself in this part of the Northern Cape, or if you're on your way to the Richtersveld Transfrontier Park, for example, then I highly recommend that you do this route. Besides being a very scenic route, it's also really cool to go through the stone cairns, and if you're gonna do that, make sure that you build one of your own too. Note that there are two Helskloof passes in the Northern Cape. One in the Richtersveld Transfrontier Park, and this one here, which is near Vioolsdrif and not too far from the Orange River. This pass is basically located between Vioolsdrif and Extienfontein. To do Helskloof Pass, I suggest you have a 4x4 vehicle with decent off-road tyres or all-terrain tyres and a couple of spares as well. The roads are quite stony from time to time, and there are a couple of steep gradients too. It's extremely hot here in the summer especially, and very remote. You are unlikely to meet other vehicles on this route. This is a really inhospitable environment, and you don't want to get stuck here. If you do get stuck here, walking is going to be a significant distance to the nearest settlement to get help, and it's going to be an unpleasant hot walk too. There are no shops or fuel or services of any kind around here. The nearest places you'll get those are in Vioolsdrif or in Extienfontein. Those are each about 30 kilometers away, however, it's a very slow going 30 kilometers. I hope you found this informative, and I hope it inspires you to get off the beaten track. If you did, hit the like button, leave a comment below, leave a question if you have one, and also subscribe if you haven't already. And until the next episode, go everywhere, see everything, have a great time.